stuff out of it. This is a one-hour-long breakout session. There'll be a short 15-minute break afterwards, followed by another breakout session from 11 to noon. So this session is titled the Social Media Checklist. So if you're not in the right room and you want to go to a new session, you can go and leave now. But we have lots of people. There is still a couple chairs left around, so you can be standing. But as we get through, so I want to give a warm welcome to our presenters. We have Danielle Mitchell and Maya Harris. And they'll be presenting the social media checklist.
So, hello everyone. My name is Danielle Mitchell, and I'm the creator of Atlas Black Girl, which is a boutique marketing firm where I was able to take my lifestyle blog and turn it into a marketing firm. And then I have Melon and Dish, which is the parent team, and that is where we go after government contracts and things like that. So a little bit about me. So far this year, I've been able to have one of my clients be in front of 73,000 live views, getting them an interview with the BlackDoctor.org as they release one of their books called The Books of Perseverance. I've been able to personally increase my social media likes over 2 months by 100%. I'm sorry, 1,000%. I've been able to increase my LinkedIn by 400%. So we've gone from about 2,000 followers to almost 8,000 followers. And we're going to talk about what I did, how we did it, and how you can do it too for not only your brands, but for your businesses. I'm also an alum for Google Live. We both are, so.
Your goals, you want to identify your landmarks, create action steps, And then, of course, celebrate your wins. So one of the ways that I personally like to goal set is the rule of three. This is something that I learned at my previous company. Our boss kind of laid it out for us, where if you set three simple tasks a day, you'll be able to reach your goals quicker and you'll feel more accomplished. Many times we have a really long laundry list of things that we need to do, things that we need to accomplish, and it gets overwhelming. So the best way to reach your bigger goals is to break down the list, three of the most important things that you need to get done that day. And the idea behind it is that even if you don't accomplish all three things, let's say you get two of those things done, that's 67% of your checklist already done, as opposed to only getting done two things on a list of 20. So you want to break down all of your goals into things that just are a little bit more manageable, a little bit more attainable for you.
Correct. And then one thing that I do, especially when it comes to marketing, you want to know where you're at every month. So whether you're using, like I do a Google Drive because I have a team and I want everybody to be around, I'll say, okay, for our last 28 days, how many visitors do we have? You should have a number. And then next month it should go up. If it didn't go up, then we're doing something wrong. Same thing with Facebook, LinkedIn, whatever you're tracking, you should know how many people do you have. Let's start that out, and let's never have that same number. It should always be growing. So now I'm going to talk about a little bit of the website views. So the one thing I want to talk about, because this is going to be so useful throughout all of your social media, is your freebie. Now, what is your freebie? Your freebie is what we call the big juicy carrot. It's something that is so good that I can't wait to give you my information. So what is it? It's something that is of value, but it's not so much of value that you feel like bad about giving it away. So it should maybe be something that is $50 or less in value. Now, it doesn't have to be things. Like, people always say, well, I'm going to give out t-shirts or pins, but that's a cost. You want something that doesn't cost you anything, but you're still giving it to you. So what does that look like? That can look like a PDF that you can create that looks really cute, right? You can pay for a template, or you can, if you're graphic enough, then you can go ahead and create your own, and you can do it on Canva, which is a free platform. But if you're not, then I would go ahead and invest for something that is very nice. It has great graphic, it has great stuff, and the things that you have. Although, if I'm a do-it-yourselfer, I can Google it, I don't want to. Or it will take me hours to find that information. So it is of value. Now, if you want to go to the next step, and maybe you already have your freebie, then you maybe want to do an online course. So the course platform that I use is Teachable. I use it because it's very user-friendly, and they have a free plan, and then you can pay as you grow. And I just am a fan of paying as you grow, because as you're trying something, what may work for her may not work for me. And I don't know, and I don't like having high risk, low reward type thing. So for me, Teachable works, and that's what I use. So now it's a 3-day thing. It took me, I felt like, 40 hours to create it, but now it's done. And now that I'm creating it, I can sell it all year. And I can just, if I need to add something, if LinkedIn changes something, it's just one chapter that could change. I can make everything new. So that is one of the things that you want to do. Now, with your freebie, you want to make sure that it's above the fold. So above the fold is an old term that people use for newspapers, but for websites, it's before you start scrolling down. So I want to make sure that I see it and I'm able to dive into it. So mine says, make your LinkedIn irresistible within 72 hours, and it has a button, and I make it into a button because people like buttons. Even though it's not a real button, just make it seem like that. I have done the same thing for my Facebook header. It looks like a button. When people click it, then with the header, instead of the comments being on the bottom or on the side, then people can click the link. But if people know that that's what works, right? Same thing with having a golden egg. I don't know why, but golden eggs get more clicks. So you can use anything and have a golden egg, and studies show that people will buy into that. So do I question it? No. I just say, this is what works. I'm going to go. And I'm also going to tell everybody around, like, this is what works. You don't have to think about it. So that's the first thing you want to do. Yes?
Can you explain to us a little bit about what a golden egg is?
But just a picture of a golden egg. I don't know why, but try it, it will work. sometimes people don't understand, right? You're into your science or whatever you're really niched into, and it makes sense to you. But if I've never seen what you're talking about, doesn't make sense to me. What I do is I show my dad, right? He's not a marketer, so if it makes sense to him, then I know I'm in. But my friends, my business besties, we're too far into it that it's like way far gone, they'll understand. So you want to talk to someone that is not in your industry at all and see, do they know how to navigate your site? And what I like doing is I like having options already there. So I have, for my web design, a business in a box. It is web design, marketing, logos, it's everything. And it's my most expensive package. I can couple it all in, but I can guarantee that you're gonna have these different things. Then I'll have one for just the web design, and then I'll have one for updating your website. So people already know, okay, we can definitely customize, but am I in the right range? Do I like her styles, her samples? Do you have samples of what you're talking about? And is it easy to navigate? And so you want to make sure that the first part of what you're talking about makes sense. The jargon, that's cool, but is it too much jargon that your audience doesn't understand what you're working for? So making sure that your site is simple. Now, you don't have to be super clean. Like, people think that simple means there's a one layout and I have like four things. No, if you have a lot of information, cool. You want to make sure that it makes sense and that people can navigate through it. So having someone, like I said, having someone that is not in your industry is definitely who you want to go to. Okay, so now we're going to talk about social media. So the first thing I want to talk about is LinkedIn again. So LinkedIn is my favorite because it gives you a lot of results without having to do a lot. So LinkedIn knows, first of all, why LinkedIn. One, LinkedIn has 44% of people make $75,000 or more, right? So you have people that make money. Then you have a large percentage, 13% of people on LinkedIn are not on Twitter. And you have a higher percentage of LinkedIn that are not on Facebook. So unlike the other ones where if I post on Facebook and I post on Instagram, I'm going to have a mix of the same people. For LinkedIn, you're really having an audience that is super unique to themselves. Also, they got money, so if you're looking for a paid client, you want to get on LinkedIn. So one thing that I use for my LinkedIn is I look at why more people want to work with me. So one, they think that I am younger than I am. They don't believe that I have the brains that I've worked with. And they want to know, have I worked with someone that looks like them? So age-wise, business-wise, academic history, socioeconomic status, have I worked with someone? And so with LinkedIn, you can have people give you reviews. So it's like your own personal Yelp for you. Like your brand and having that great website drives people in, but as a small business owner or as someone that is growing, you are ultimately going to be the person that gives you or that either sells the deal or lands the deal. So people want to work with you. They want to like you. They want to know, do I like the way she talks? Do I like her talking style? Do I like her teaching style? Like all that comes to play. And so for me, when I Google myself, LinkedIn was the first thing that comes up. So I'm going to make sure that the first thing that comes up is perfect. And you should too. You should Google yourself and say, okay, what's coming up? Maybe if you're a lawyer and you want an ABBO, then you need to make sure that is perfect. Whatever it is, perfect it. So for LinkedIn, what you want to do is you want to make sure that your profile is great. Now, the first thing that people do is your tagline is going to be the first thing of your work history. So it'll say account manager. Well, what is that? An account manager can be so different to so many things. If I'm an account manager for Coca-Cola versus I'm an account manager for a medical supplies, it can be something completely different. I need to know what it is that you do. So for me, I wouldn't say I'm a founder. Like, again, what is that? I say that I'm an international marketing strategist. People already know, okay, she has global brands. That's what she does. Me being a founder means nothing to people, and I want people to know who I'm talking to. Then I take it one step further, and I say I'm looking to work with people that are either in school or working. That means that I'm not looking for people that don't have money to pay me. And I'm talking to them directly. And then I put in one more sentence. I say I'm looking for people to like garner their side hustle. So So that's a little sappy. So with those things, I'm not being mean. I'm not even not targeting people. I'm just strictly directing in my energy and my image to my target audience. And they know I am, so they come to me. What I like to tell people is think of it like a shoe store, right? Everybody wants to have shoes and they want to show it to everyone. But do you think that Beyonce and Serena Williams are looking at the same shoe? No. Serena Williams has bigger feet and she has a little bit of style plus sport. Not Beyonce at all, right? So will Beyonce come and maybe buy some shoes that is directed towards Serena? Yeah. But then she's gonna go back to her Target. People that I'm talking to every day. I may try you for Halloween, but I'm going back to people that talk to me all day, every day. So you want to do the same thing for yourself. Then your profile. So what is in the profile? The profile, what most people do is they'll say, oh, I'm going to work for my company. And you don't make a company page. When you don't make a company page, then your company icon is grayed out and it looks very, very unprofessional. You can create a company page for free, put in your icon, it just makes you that much better. And then you're gonna wanna go down and start creating content. I think that you only need to create content 2 times a month, 1st and 15th. Why? Because people don't go on LinkedIn every day. Sometimes they don't even go on every month. It could be very generational or situational. I'm looking for a job, I'm looking for a partnership, I'm looking for something. So if you have an article that shows that you are the subject matter expert, so how to's, 10 steps, what did I learn? How did I increase my blank by blank in 36 months? Those things will get people to show that, one, I'm the expert. Two, I know what I'm talking about in my industry. And three, you're gonna want to work for me or work with me. And then the last thing that I tell people is there's actually an extension that you can use now, a Chrome extension. It's called the LinkedIn Helper, and that's an automation tool. So this is how you're able to increase your likes and your connections in your sleep. So what you can do is, call LinkedIn Helper and you can first find your target. What is your target? Your target is going to be maybe marketing that will fit in the Chicagoland area. And then I create a custom message that says, hi, first name, I'm looking to connect with marketing individuals in the Chicagoland area. I'll do Chicago for maybe a week, then I'll go to Atlanta, then I'll go to LA. I'll go to wherever I'm trying to make my mark so that when I'm trying to do speaking engagements or brands or whatever, these are the people that I'm looking for. And then I'll say, okay, I'm done with partnerships, and I'm going to look for my client. So then I'm going to look for lawyers, I'm going to look for engineers, I'm going to look for those techie people that have ideas but maybe are a little more shy and need my marketing help. So that's what I'm looking for. Because I know who they are, boom. And you can search by name, first name, last name. You can search by college. You can search by geographic region. You can search worldwide. Like LinkedIn has a lot of international as well. So the options are endless, but that is how you do LinkedIn. Okay, so now we're going to talk about Facebook. So Facebook, one thing that people do. So Facebook doesn't know what they want to do. First, they want you to promote and do business page. Now they went back to personal. So people are like, I don't know what to do with Facebook. I'm just overwhelmed. What you need to do is you need to join groups, because groups algorithm is different than those two algorithms. Groups algorithms are made to consume. So when you post in groups, more people are going to see it. So what does that mean? You need to find groups of people that you connect with, and then also you need to find groups of where your target is. I'm not a mom, but I'm in the Chicago Hustle Moms group like all day, every day, because those are my clients, those are my customers. They already say, one, you're a mom, so you have a family, cool. Two, you probably have a career if you're a mom. Three, hustle mommies, that means that you're trying to start your business. That's perfect, that is who I want to work with, and so I'm there all the time. Then I'm in people where I'm not, right? So there's like tech there, I'm in charge of, I think, Nesby. I'm not an engineer, but that's who I want to be with. So you want to find people that are your likes and then are your target. And then what you want to do as far as, a lot of people don't talk about how to use Facebook ads cheaper with getting more.
All right, well, thank you so much, my above average crew, for following with me on that speaking engagement. Please like the video, hit that subscribe button, and let's get the comment section popping. I'll see you next time. Bye.